and welcome to my channel. Today I've got a body paint tutorial for you because it's like a gazillion degrees Celsius in the attic here. Well, not literally, but it's really hot here. So I figured filming a makeup tutorial, well, I would just sweat everything off within like 12 seconds. So I decided to go for body paint instead. In case anyone was wondering, yes, you can apply body paint over sunscreen. I just did. I just don't know how well the sunscreen is still going to last unless it's really, really water resistant. But anyway, yeah, this is basically what we're going to go for, but with a twist. More about it in a moment. Without further ado, let's get started. Okay, I'm wearing a bandeau top, or at least I was planning on wearing a bandeau top, and I really, for the life of me, couldn't find it. Like, it's not in my underwear drawer, so I'm at a loss. I just don't know where it is. So instead I'm just wearing a play suit that also happens to have no sleeves. Works as well. First thing I'm gonna do is just mixing blue and white to create a pale blue. This doesn't need to be even or anything, I'm just going for a bit of a sketchy style as a background, and then for more of my regular cartoony style for the foreground. So yeah, just toss it under. Now I'm just using regular white body paint for some clouds. Again for the backdrop, so they don't need to be neat. I'm just basically stamping the petal brush on. Actually my regular everyday foundation brush. So I get sort of a cloud-like effect. Okay, next up I'm gonna paint some trees. And my idea is basically as if you're looking up at the sky and you see some bits of trees but don't see the full tree, if you get my drift. You know, you don't see the grounds. Very eloquent. You'll understand when I actually do it. But yeah, for that I'm just going to use a smaller brush. Now the trees, as you can already tell, are going to be very simple. You can do either a leafy tree or a needle tree. Believe it or not, but I did actually learn stuff like that in high school. I just forgot all about it. Anyway, for either tree it's basically the same thing. Just make sure your brush is clean. Mine was still filled up with the green stuff from the trees. Oops. And go into a brown body paint. I don't know what happened to my brown body paint, but it's like scattered in like 500 bits. I have no idea. And just put a tree trunk somewhere. Actually, I'm going to put two tree trunks on this side. And then I'm just going to try to remember what I saw in those Bob Ross videos and try to not overcomplicate it. Try to just make a tree without, you know, being all that detailed about it. Go for the effect and not for like too much effort, basically. Yep. So I'm just going to go into a middle green and sort of dot on the tree. And the other tree as well. Oh, and remember. We were not going to add ground to it. So the trunk needs to be covered. And this tree starts a little bit higher, it's probably standing a little bit further away. So I'm just going to put that up a little bit higher. And like so. And of course it looks kind of flat, so now I'm wiping down my brush again and just going into a other shade of green, a more darker green. First off, just making sure that I get a little bit of an edge here where one tree starts and the other one ends. For realism and all, and then just randomly dotting on some dark green to make it more shaded. Also, by the way, in case you're wondering how I'm sitting higher than in my regular makeup tutorials where I just show my face. No, I didn't aim the camera differently because that didn't work with my backdrop system. I'm sitting on a cardboard box filled with Donald Duck comic books. Nobody cared about that, but I thought I'd tell you anyway. But yeah, just make sure you keep dotting until it's, you know, until you actually have the result you want, but make sure you don't go on too long, because otherwise you'll just end up, well, basically with a mixed color instead of shading. So keep that in mind. Now I was going to go on to making a little sun, and then I realized I could also just add some more stripes. I did this entire tree with stripes, but add some more stripes with a thinner brush in yellow. Just to give it a little bit more depth, and there is a little bit of green in my yellow, and it's also mixing with the green on my body, so we're getting sort of a yellowish golden green out of it. Not a pure green, of course. Not a pure yellow was what I meant to say, because I, again, don't want the trees to look dead and decaying. So yeah, but this just again gives a little bit more depth. I also did it on the other trees with some more dots. But yeah, just to make sure that the trees look a little bit more 3D-ish. Just a little bit more interesting. And also, I particularly did three trees. That sounds funny. Anyway, because I once heard that a rule of decoration is that you always need to add an uneven number. Unless the number is great enough that you can't really count it with one glance anyway. So I went for three trees instead of two because rules of decoration. Then I'm going to add some flying mustaches, aka the really easy way to paint birds, by just making them vaguely look like a mustache. There's some different sizes and groups, and again, rule of decoration, I'm trying to make uneven numbers of birds. And you know, they can be anything you want, they can be an eagle, they can be, I don't know, a seagull. I don't know if there would be a sea anywhere near these trees, but that's not the point. I don't really care, they could be a monstrous thing from prehistoric times, as long as they're there to just fill up the empty spaces. Then I almost actually forgot to still paint my sun. I have yellow all over my fingers now. The sun is melting. Anyway, I'm just going to... Where am I going to add the thing? I'm going to add it there. Okay, that's on there. Now I'm just adding some sun rays with the liner brush that I used for the mustache birds. Obviously, I did wipe it down well. Because I don't want shadowy sun rays. And make sure that you don't pull the sun rays over anything else. You can pull them a little bit through the clouds because it doesn't matter. But don't pull them over the trees because that's not logical. Okay, so the cardboard box by now is getting sort of soggy with sweat because it's really hot here. Annoying. Don't recommend it. Anyway. But now it's on to the experimental part. I'm going to use a Dayglow color. This one is by Crayola and I really like their UV paints. But anyway, I'm going to use the eyeliner brush to add some details with this paint. And then the idea is that if I put on black light instead of normal light, it's going to go from a day landscape to a night landscape. Let's try it out. I'm just adding some dots that could be normal flies in daytime, but fireflies at night. Oh, and also, by the way, the reason I'm doing this particular look is I recently did a blacklight shoot with a photographer and a model, obviously. And I don't know, blacklight is just so fun to work with, yet I barely ever do it because you need a blacklight lamp for it to show. And most people, surprisingly, don't actually have random blacklight lamps at home that they randomly put on. I don't even. I do have a blacklight lamp, but even I don't randomly put it on. So, you know, like, it never seems very useful to do for YouTube because it's just so, you know, something that not a lot of people are going to actually try out for themselves. So I figured why not try to combine it with something else. And if this actually works out, I might actually try it with different designs as well. Maybe some creatures or whatever. You know, just for fun. Because blacklight is really, really fun to work with. It really is. Okay, so I think we're here. We have a cute little landscape. You could actually do this on paint if you don't have anywhere to wear this. Which wouldn't surprise me, really. Maybe if we can go to fantasy fairs again next year, this would be useful. But anyway, I'm gonna check how this works with blacklight. And it works. I have an actual blacklight lamp, but it's not strong enough, so I'm literally using my... the thing that I use to cure my gel nail polish. Anyway, but it works. Like, seriously, the trees just eat up the light because they're darker, so they look all shady and all. And the sun turned into a moon, full moon, and then there's fireflies everywhere, and it just looks like a really magical night landscape. So, you know, if you're, you know, when this entire crisis is over, are going to some kind of blacklight party, you could go as a night landscape. Just remember to bring your nail lamp. Anyway, but yeah, it works. So you're going to see more ideas with this in the future. Near future, as soon as it's not so hot anymore outside. Thank you. figured I just end it like this. Hello, stay on you. Switches off after 30 seconds. Good for nails, not for this. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you did enjoy it, please click the like button. It would really help me out. And if you want to see more of my tutorials, I actually mostly do wearable eye and face looks, actually, but still. And then you can always subscribe to my YouTube channel. For now, at any rate, thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!